All right, just another little bit of play here on the 2020 Epiphone Les Paul Custom. It's got the ebony fingerboard. It's got the top hat. Oh, tell a lie, I actually came with speed knobs. I actually put these top hats on it myself because I like that 60s, late 60s vibe. Grovers. I've heard some talk online saying, oh yeah, the Grovers they use now on Epiphones are not as good. They're really, really good. They're super smooth. I have some fake Grovers. They're rubbish compared to these ones. These ones are super smooth and take up the slack nicely. They use a newborn nut now, and you know what? It really does work. You don't get that string ding that happens. That's not happened once in this guitar. What else about it? Really nice inlay, so even though they're not mother of pearl, they've got a nice facet to them, so not plain. They look really nice. Like you could mistake them for the real thing. Gold hardware, so nice, and even a gold jack plate, which is a nice touch as well, right? So, and this has got the quite a slim neck on it, whereas the classic, the Burst one, has got a 50s neck on it, so like a fatter neck. So I like them both, actually. They both play well. Something about the ebony fingerboard, it feels hard under your fingers, and I mean that in a good way. It feels like almost like the notes are ringing off the board easier because the board is hard. That's what it feels like to me. So it's an impression of it. All right, here's a wee tune. I'll start it off with the riff, actually. It goes like this. In the song, so obviously I must be playing. It's not that I'm not playing in time, but I must not be playing 4/4/2 time, right? So it's interesting that. So I'll play it normally, and it sounds fine. I don't feel anything. Don't feel any weird gaps. But as soon as I have to follow the beat, then there's a weird gap in, right? Maybe I must start on a half note or something at some point. But I don't know if anyone else finds that as well. So sometimes I prefer just to do it without the drums, unless I'm recording it, in which case I'll force myself to go along with the rhythm, so I can then add some drum track later. But yeah, so let's see if we put on some. It's quite a versatile guitar, the Epiphone Les Paul Custom. If I put on some chorus here, check out the sound. Some chorus on it. financials, of course. Sounds off the guitar with just a small change in the amp or setting, so there's a few.